Alright, just for shits and giggles, I opened up the ballast that comes stocked with these LEDs, and you can see they're very well labeled out of the black core that comes out, and so it is pretty easy to figure out. They're actually a lot like the Meanwell drivers that I use on my Rapid LEDs. I'm sure the parts, I haven't seen half the capacitors the other ones do, but who knows, this is really convenient. But, yeah. I've already taken the top off. There's the other one. Take the top off and flip it over. It's just simple screws. And here, of course, your ballast fans, power source. Here are the two pot dimmers right here. I'll show you in a second on what I do to get this whole thing fixed up. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is locate this pot. What we're gonna do is take this plug out and separate these wires. This is the power wire right here. I'm gonna cut these two, jump them together. They're just simple power wires. These are your dimmers. You got the positive and the negative. They're sending 10 volt back to the apex. Okay, so with this wire, you can do it in a number of ways. You can get a connector that will connect right here and look nice and clean, and it goes out to a Cat5, wired deal, whatnot. But you know me, I like ghetto things, and it's going to be covered anyway. I'm not going to see any of it anyway. So you've got the power wires up here, and you've got the dimmer wires here, positive, negative. So first thing I'm going to do is cut these. Permanent. No, you'll be fine. Don't worry about it. Now you have to strip these. And you know how to strip wires, hopefully. Otherwise, you shouldn't be doing this. All right, I've got them stripped. Really doesn't matter what order they're in. As long as you get them connected. Normally, if you wanted to be not ghetto, you would keep these together and then use a jumper going from this first hole to the second hole, and then you connect this side up to other cords. But like I said, I don't care what it looks like. I have my own way of doing things, and I like the ghetto method. Now, please excuse the nastiness of my soldering pencil. I've been soldering all weekend doing this one, doing my own, using the enclosure on my own LEDs from Rapid LED. But this is just for stock Chinese. Anyway, what we're first going to do is we're going to pre-tin the wires a little bit. I put it on the bottom and I put it right over top. You got a nice clean tin from the bottom, right over top. See, it's nice and clean. Next, we're going to just go ahead and put these guys together as best you can. It's still a little bit warm. And I solder them together. Nice, easy, and clean. Alright, so now you've got your power wires together. Here's my ghetto taping job, but it seems to work. These are the power wires, they've already been jumped. Everything's fine now. Now we have left are the dimmers. Okay, next up is you get your apex wire. I've made mine out of a Cat5 tip and solid wire. I just like it because it's rigid and hard, difficult to break, and it's still pretty malleable. But anyway, I've made these. You can go online to find your tips, or I can make another video. But anyway, got your solid wire all over the ends, and I've separated these so you know these are two separate VDM cables. And I'm going to go ahead and strip these, and I'm going to solder them. All right, so we're going to do the same thing here. put the wires, and I'm going to put some solder on tip, put it underneath, and then got a nice clean flux and tin. And then put there, and it's nice and clean. All right. Next up, we're going to do one by one. First, do the top. We'll clip it off, strip it, then tin it. All right. Take our positive first. Can we get them together? Nice, clean. All right. Perfect. All right. So now we put a little on your tip. Right underneath, and sit in there. Nice clean 10. And we'll take our negative there. Perfect. Go ahead and tape these up. Okay, now you've got both wires done up where you're supposed to have them done. Now I'm going to go ahead and do the other side, and then we're going to put this back together, and I'm going to rehang the lights. They're still in the process of being fixed, so hopefully it doesn't look too ghetto for you. Anyway, all right. Here's an alternative way of doing it. Since these are solid core wires, I was able to stick them right into the plugs. If I can get it down. There we go. I was able to stick it right in there. And if you take a look, the clips on this side right here are where you should be jumping. Negative on this side, then positive of the VDM cables, and then the jumper for the positive. And the 12 volt supply and the on and off. Okay, I've got them hooked up, and this is them. This is the stock setting on the VDM expansion model. It's the same thing as your ports on your base unit. Mine fried, go figure, a while back, so I had to get the expansion model. But here it is. This is the stock programming. It just goes on, off, on, off, on, off. I'll show you the breakout box that I built in the back. Still have to mount it, but all is working. Okay, this is my expansion model, VDM module. You can see the lights on and off. It's just a stock setting. I'm going to install the module, so it's also a good test function for the lights. It seems to be working out pretty well. Thank you for watching my video. I created this for a friend, but for the rest of you out there, if you're good with your soldering skills and a little bit of a technical guy, some tools, it's really not that hard to do. I must say that I'm not liable for anything that you people do with your electric devices. If I set your house on fire, actually it's not my fault. Anyway, one last note, the dimming ability of these drivers actually won't go all the way to 0%. So in your source code, whenever you go to program your profiles for Apex, make sure that when you have a dimming, it's not an off feature at whatever specific time you'd like them to completely turn off. I applied this to my light strip profile. To turn off the complete light strip and then have it turn back on after my ramp up profile had completed. I believe it, I had set it 30 minutes. Nonetheless, I hope you enjoyed this, and go ahead and comment if you have any questions.